courageous families, courageous kids, dealing with big feelings during challenging times. Presented by Redwood Credit Union.
Hi, I'm Brett Martinez, President and CEO of Redwood Credit Union. At RCU, we recognize families are facing many different challenges right now, and we want you to know that we're here to help. We believe all of us in the community play a role in educating our kids and helping them become more confident. That's why we're offering this video featuring Jennifer Miller, author of Confident Parents, Confident Kids. She'll offer some tips to recognize, understand, and manage your feelings in a positive way. I want you to know we are always here to support you in any way that we can, and all of us at RCU wish you and your families the very best.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Miller, author of Confident Parents, Confident Kids, and I have some great family and friends who are helping me act out my top tips for how you deal with those big feelings. Let's get started. Tip number one, freeze. When you feel your temperature heat up, your heart beat fast, your forehead wrinkle, you know you're having a big feeling. That feeling is an important warning signal. Something's got you upset, but you may not be sure exactly why. So it's time to freeze. Tip number two, warm up with hot chocolate breathing. After you freeze, it's time to warm up. A great way to help you remember to deeply breathe is by using hot chocolate breathing. Grab your pretend mug of hot cocoa and deeply take in the aroma of the hot chocolate. Now blow on your hot cocoa to gently cool it. Do this a few times by taking in deeply the smell of the chocolate and gently blowing to cool it. Tip number three. Tell your feeling. When you name a feeling, you begin to calm down by telling a caring adult. So tell me, how were you feeling when you froze in place?
I felt frustrated.
And after freezing, breathing, and then saying how you feel, now how are you feeling?
I feel better.
Remember that you can have a couple feelings at once, including opposite feelings like happy and sad. Okay, parents and caregivers, here's how you can support your children through their big feelings. Here are my top five strategies for adults. Take your own time out when you feel overwhelmed, stressed, angry, or impatient. Model self-management skills by stopping, breathing, and calming down first before responding to your family. Practice the freeze, breathe, and tell steps together when all is calm. Post a reminder where it's visible to all family members so it can be pointed to when a child is upset. Do regular feelings check-ins. Use daily feelings words with your children so that they develop their own feelings vocabulary. Brainstorm a list of ways families can feel better. These are healthy coping strategies like hugging a pillow, drawing with crayons, or walking outside. Keep this list at the ready so that you can use it when emotions run high. This is a time when we are called to show compassion for one another's big feelings, recognizing that they are normal. If big feelings are expected, then we can plan to respond to them in ways that keep all family members safe and on the road to feeling better.
You are not alone.
You are awesome. You got this.
You got this. We support you.
We are
in this
together.
You got this.
We care about you.
We care.
We are with you.
We're with you.